Hello everyone and welcome to this series on JMeter beginner tutorial. So this is the 8th session and today we will see how do we test a FTP server with JMeter. So let's begin, and the first step will be we have to add a FTP request sampler. Okay, so go to your JMeter and I have a test plan here, a new test plan. I'm going to add a thread group, and inside the thread group I will add an FTP request sampler. Okay, now if you look at this FTP request sample, we have to give some parameters like a server name, the port number, the remote file location, the local file location, and then we have this username and password to access the FTP location. Okay, so in your case you must be having your FTP server details available with you and all the username and passwords. For this tutorial and for this session, let us use a publicly available FTP location. So this is the site I'm going to, and I'll also mention this here. This is the site, and this provides us a publicly available FTP location which we can actually use to test and upload and download of a file. And here are the details. So we are going to connect to this FTP location using this server name. So I'll put the server name here, and the username is anonymous. I'll put username, and it says use your email address as password, right? So you can use any valid email address as your password here. Okay, now you see we can either retrieve using get, retrieve a file from FTP to our local system, or we can transfer a file from our local system to the FTP location using put. So let us see how to do a get first. Okay, and to do a get we have to add the location of the remote file. Okay, now how do we know what file is there and what is the location of that file? To know that, I'll actually have to go to this particular FTP location and check. In your case you must already be knowing the location of your file, but because I do not know it and this is a public FTP, so I will just connect to this FTP to validate. So I'm going to FileZilla. I'm giving this server name is this, so I'll put the host here, username here, some email ID here, and I will say connect. So you can see this particular right pane here, this is the FTP server and all the details and the files will be listed here, and this particular section on the left side, this is my local system. Okay, now this has the connection is successful and I can actually see all these files here. Okay, so what will we do is we will try to retrieve some file from this FTP location to our local system, and let us try to fetch this particular text file which is readme.txt to our local system here. Okay, so I'll say get file readme.txt from the server, and I have to also mention the local file location. Okay, so I want it to be placed here. And I can also give some name. So let me give the same name. I can also give some different name here. Okay, and now our FTP request is ready. So we have to run and validate it. Okay, so what we have done is step two is we have added some FTP connection parameters, and now step three is test a FTP get and validate. Okay, So our request is ready. To validate, we need to add some listeners. So I will again right click on thread group, go to add, go to listeners, and let us add a tree listener. And let me also add one more listener. Let me add a table listener. Okay, so we have two listeners to validate our request. And now I can run this. I can also save this. So my test has started, and you can see this single request went to the server and it is successful. It is showing me a response code of 200 and other details. And again, I can see in the table, this is the sample time and this is the bytes and latency and all that. So now I can increase my thread group. I can say 5 here and I can run it again. So now you can see we are getting all successful results, but here we should also validate that whether it has transferred the file from the FTP server to our local system. For that, let us go here and let me refresh this. You can see as of now the readme.txt file is not available here. I'll refresh it, and yes, the file got transferred from this FTP location to my local system. Okay, so the FTP get is successful, and let me name this as FTP request get. Okay, let us also see a FTP post. So step 4 is test FTP post and validate. Okay, so I'm just copying this request again here. Okay, I'll name is FTP put. I should also use put instead of post. Okay, now here the thing I'm going to change is instead of this get, I'll say put. Okay, and I have to select the remote directory where I have to put my file. Okay, so let me again go to my FileZilla and let me go to some particular directory which is accessible. Okay, I can use this pub incoming directory to put my file from my local system to the FTP location. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the same file which was downloaded from FTP, and now I'm going to put this file to some different location on the FTP server. And just for validation, let me rename this file to some unique name so that I will come to know that this file got transferred successfully or not. Okay. Okay. So this our FTP put request is again ready, and let me just check this. I am putting user as 1 again. Okay, and I have triggered the test again. Okay, so now we have two requests. One is FTP get and one is FTP put. So FTP get got successful. Okay, and now it is doing FTP put, and yes, FTP put is also successful. And if I go to my table listener, yes, I can see this is the sample time and status and bytes and all those things for FTP get and put. But yes, now I have to validate physically if the file is transferred. So I will go here and I will do a refresh. So we transferred a file, and the name we used was readme123.txt. So this particular file with this name should be present in the directory pub incoming on the FTP location. So let me refresh this, and yes, you can see readme123.txt got transferred from here to here from my local system to the FTP server, and you can see all these details here, right? Okay, so now because I have validated both FTP GET and FTP PUT, now what I can do is I can increase the number of threads to whatever requirement I have and then run the test again. Okay, there's one other thing. If there are some other parameters that we should know, this is an option used binary mode. So by default, if it is not checked, it uses an ASCII mode for transfer, and ASCII is used normally for the text files, and binary mode is used for zip files and image files and all those things, right? Although it depends on your requirement. Do you want to need a binary mode or an ASCII mode? Okay, and the other option we have is save file in response. So what does this mean? If you go to the results and if you go to the tree, I go to FTP request get, I click on request, this is the request that went, and now you can see this is ASCII because we have not selected binary mode, and in the response data it is empty. Okay, now if I say save file in response and run this test again, let us see what it shows now. Okay, so it has given us, this is the sample result request, and in the response data it has actually shown the entire file which we got from FTP. Okay, so this is the use of this save file in response. So this option is good for validating that your test is proper and it is getting the actual file. When you want to do a proper performance test, it's better to switch this off because it will take some memory. And again, view results in tree is a listener which takes up some memory, and we need to disable it when we are doing our actual test. It is good for validating the test is configured properly, but when you are doing a test with multiple users, it is better to switch this off and use other listeners. Okay, so this is how we do a FTP upload and download using JMeter. And there is one more logical controller which is called as it's a config element called as FTP request defaults. Okay, now what does this mean is, if you are doing all your testing with a single server, FTP server, you can give the server name here, and then in your different requests you do not have to give the server name again. Okay, it will take the server name from here and the rest of the details from your request, FTP request sampler. Okay, so this is how we do a FTP upload and download using JMeter. Hope you like it. Thank you.